Here's my Paul Newman story. So I go to Indianapolis for the 500-mile race. Mm-hmm. Held every year. By the way, in doing this, I was able to really anger the wife of the governor of the state of Indiana. So ask me about that tomorrow.
Okay, we'll say that.
So I see Paul. I'm there with my friends. I'm there with my friends, and I see Paul Newman. At a certain place at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, which is a vast facility, huge, enormous, 500,000 people attending this event. I see Paul Newman, he's going up a set of stairs. Listen how quiet he is. That's the sign of a good storyteller. if you can, yeah, I can. Oh, look at this, there's our, see, we're doing the best we can without writers. We've added this, that's our security camera. Yeah, that guy's up to no good. So I see, now I'm in show business,
yes.
and of course, Paul Newman is in show business, so I think to myself, I can say hello to Paul Newman and also impress my friends, see? So Paul is dressed all in white. Well, you're giving me time cues? Our biggest goal here tonight is to kill time. What? No, you should have come to the meeting. No, we're trying to... Forget the time cues. We got to eat as much time as we possibly can. Because normally in this position, there'd be
written
fantastic
material.
Written comedy, but thanks to the money-grubbing scum, we don't have any. So, anyway, Paul, and he's dressed completely in white. He's got white pants, a white shirt, and a little white hat. He looked like an extra on the Love Boat.
Okay.
But I know it's Paul Newman, because there's no mistaking this man. So, and we're about 5 feet away. I'll stand up for no apparent reason. And I'm surrounded by my little friends that I've brought to the Indianapolis Motor Speedway to try and impress them with what's going on. Paul Newman walks over, and he makes a right turn and goes up a flight of stairs. And I said, "Hi, Paul." All right. Now, Paul says and does this. He continues to walk. This is what Paul does. So I'm in Phoenix now. I'm attending an automobile race a couple of years ago. And there's a race driver named Bobby Rahal.
Yeah.
Great driver. Won Indianapolis in 86.
That's right.
Two-time national champion. And I'm spending some time with his wife. She's being nice to me, showing me around. And she says to me, "Would you like to meet Paul Newman?" And I think, well, geez, normally, you know, if she said, "Would you like to meet that Hey Vern guy?" Well, no, I'd have passed on that. So she goes into his trailer, and by God, there's Paul Newman. And I'm stunned, because this guy is really a star, a major movie star. He's been in films, HUD, The Verdict, on and on, the Butch Cassidy, The Sundance Kid, all of them. A great actor and a great star. And the only thing I can think to say to him is, "Geez, I really enjoy your popcorn." That's the only But we go on and we have a nice little dialogue, and I'm beginning to think, geez, maybe we're friends now. Paul Newman and I, because we've chatted, we know one another, we're both at the race, we both know Debbie Rahal. Okay, so now, a couple of months later, I'm at Indianapolis, also at a race. They have a race there. And I see Paul Newman again, and I think this is my chance to impress this young woman that I'm with. I think this will just drive her nuts, because Paul Newman is coming up these stairs. He has a little white outfit on, white shoes, white pants, white shirt, little white hat. Like he's pretending to be in the Navy, this kind of thing. And so I normally wouldn't do this. I stand up and I see him and I said, "Hi, Paul," just like that. And the girl is right here. Paul does this. And keeps walking.
True story?
It's a true story. Yes, it's a true story.
And the end of the story?
Just go to the commercial.
Oh, I see.
Want to do a... That's a drum roll to the deck.
Man!
And we'll be right back.